Hello learners, today we are going to study the poem The Female of the Species written by Gauri Deshpande. In this lesson, we tried to critically analyze the poem and to see the feminist concerns in the poem, especially the way the Indian woman is depicted in the poem. It is a short poem and a simple poem which depicts a typical Indian gathering of housewives where they sit together, have tea and talk about the problems that bother them, especially about their children. This poem gives a moving yet poignant picture of a typical Indian mother and also how a typical group of women in India sit together and talk. This poem, The Female of the Species, written by Gauri Deshpande, is taken from her first collection of poetry, Between Births, which was published in the year 1968. Before we go into a detailed study of the poem, it is important to have an overview of the poet, her life and the influences on her writing, the themes and major concerns in her writing, especially in her poetry. Gauri Deshpande was a novelist, short story writer, translator, social activist and a poet. She was a bilingual writer, writing equally well in English and Marathi. She is considered as one among the foremost women poets writing in English in India. She is also known for expressing herself boldly and fearlessly. In her writings, she questions the hypocritical societal behaviors. Her concerns in her writing and the way she expresses herself marks a striking similarity with another prominent female poet, Kamala Das, her contemporary, who was also a pioneer like Gauri Deshpande. However, it is interesting to note that her writing moves across time in the sense that even the next generations of poets has similarities with her. For instance, Gauri Deshpande's concern for the working middle class women is also evident in the poetry of another poet, Mabda Kalia, a poet who wrote in the 1990s. Hence, it is important to go deep into the life and works of the poet Gauri Deshpande in order to understand the factors that made her a contemporary to two generations of poets. Another fact that is evident from these aspects is that Gauri Deshpande's poetry has something important and socially relevant to communicate. In addition to that, the relevance of her poetry is also something that is important to the present times, especially when it comes to the depiction of women, particularly the middle class, modern, metropolitan women in her poetry. In order to understand the writing of any author, it is important to look into his or her life and to observe the factors that might have influenced the writer. When it comes to Gauri Deshpande, she was born into an illustrious family of intellectuals and social reformers in Pune, Maharashtra. Her mother, Airavati Karve, was a renowned anthropologist, educationist and writer. Her father, Dinakar Karve, was a son of Dondo Keshav Karve, a famous social reformer and an ardent campaigner for women's welfare. One of her brothers, Anand, runs an NGO named Aarti in Pune, and her other brother, Jay Nimkar, is also a writer. From this, it is evident that the concern for society and the welfare of the people around her was a concern for the family in which Deshpande was born into. This social consciousness is evident in most of her works. In addition to that, her rare poetic insight enabled her to see clearly and interpret intelligently the minute details that make and break the broken, disjointed and neurotic modern Indian society. Her poetry is a unique combination of imagination and judgment. Her basic education was done in Ahilya Devi School. She did her post-graduation in English Literature from the Ferguson College. She also has a doctoral degree, PhD, from Pune University. Deshpande has two daughters with her first husband, Avinash Deshpande, one of whom, Urmila Deshpande, is also a writer. She also has another daughter with the naval architect, Surinder Singh. It is interesting to note that motherhood in its many avatars is an underlining theme in her works, especially the relationship between mother and daughter, and also the many facets of the relationship between a husband and a wife. All these aspects which we find in her poetry is a reflection of her life. From her poetry, it is clear that she focuses more on society and its effects on relationship at many levels. It is clear from her biography itself that this sense of social consciousness has been a constant part of her life right from her childhood. Her marital life and her relationship with her daughters is inevitably linked to her poetry. She is primarily concerned about the exploration of the various intricacies and inner conflicts of man-women relationships. She is outspoken, forthright, and upfront in her articulation. There are many poems of hers in which she depicts women as being disheartened and dismayed because they are not satisfied with their relationships. This sense of non-fulfillment is portrayed not just on the emotional front, but also on the physical front. The bold articulation of such aspects in her poetry does have an inevitable watermark of experience. As you have already seen, she is a novelist, she is a short story writer, she is a translator and also a poet. However, she has gained much recognition as a woman poet writing in English. She can be rightly and justly described as one of the stalwarts among the Indian women writers writing in English. This is attested especially by her oeuvre of poetry written in English. Her major publications in English include three volumes of poetry. Her first volume, Between Births, was published in 1968. Her second volume, Lost Love, was published in 1970. And her final and third volume of poetry, Beyond the Slaughterhouse, was published in 1972. She started writing poetry in English at a crucial time in the history of Indian English writing. The 1960s was the time when Indian English poetry started off on a new journey, when poets like Nisim Essekil and Kamala Das began a new trend of modernism in Indian English poetry. If one is to examine the works of Gauri Deshpande, there are many similarities with these writers, not just in the way of expression and articulation, but also in the way her themes are dealt. Like Nisim Essekil and Kamala Das, Gauri Deshpande feels no reservations or moral inhibitions about making confessions of her physical experiences. This is evident when we look at the themes of her poetry. Her major concerns include the various aspects of love, sex, and marital relationships, which is evident right from her first collection, Between Births, and her second collection, Lost Love. It is only in her third collection that she moves to the wider space and writes about the milieu in which she lived. Nevertheless, it is clearly noted that her major concern is with women's life, especially the life of women in the modern metropolitan Indian society. Gauri Deshpande translated the Marathi books written by Sunidha Deshpande, Ahe Manohar Tari, into English as Pine for What Is Not, and Avinash Dharmadikari's Ashwata Dashkari Diary as Diary of a Decade of Agony. Deliverance, Gauri Deshpande's novel in Marathi, was translated into English by Shashi Deshpande. Gauri Deshpande had never planned to write in Marathi. However, after the death of her mother, Airavati Karve, in 1970, Gauri wrote an article in memory of her mother in a newspaper, which was well received. Thus, the doors of Marathi literature were opened out for her. Her collection of short stories, Ek Paan Galavaya, is a collection of three short stories which are centered around the lives of women. She has also translated 10 volumes of Sir Richard Burton's Arabian Nights into Marathi, which were published between 1976 and 1977. Even though we are studying only one poem of Gauri Deshpande, it is necessary to know about the entire collection of her poetry to assess her poems. This would also help towards a better and critical understanding of the poem we have to study, that is, the Female of the Species. We have already got a clear picture of the concerns and mode of expression in Gauri Deshpande's work. It is clear from whatever we have seen so far of her writing that poetry is a medium for Gauri Deshpande to analyze the complexities of human relationships and human existence. Right from her first collection, Between Births, this is evident. The poems in this collection, like A Change of Seasons, Migraine, Family Portraits, The Female of the Species, etc., captures sensitively the frustration and alienation that creeps into relationships. This collection of poetry also brings to the forefront one of Gauri Deshpande's major concern, the women and the times in which the women lived. As we will see in the poem, The Female of the Species, she depicts the urge of the women to share their pains and pleasures with other women. Her second collection of poetry, Lost Love, explores man-women relationships and love in various aspects. In this collection of poetry, however, she breaks away from conventional love and talks about themes as varied as sexual love, abortion, barrenness, old age, the dilemma of loss, love, etc., through poems such as The Eclipse and December. The societal concern in her poetry comes to the forefront through her last collection of poetry, Beyond the Slaughterhouse. Most of the poems here are about women in a metropolitan city and how they deal with the loss of self and love. The existential angst of the modern Indian women is the main theme of her poetry. This is often associated with the inability to form meaningful relationships. Women and the times in which she lived is also a major central concern of Gauri Deshpande's poetry. She also focuses on the various aspects of love, sex, and marital relationships. The note of sadness and loss is an evident presence in her poetry, which is clear from poems like A Change of Seasons, Family Portraits, Migraine, etc. Undercurrents of disillusionment and boredom, a part of modern life, is present to a large extent in her works. Loneliness is also communicated through her poems like The Air Fills, Known in the City, I Wanted to Weep, etc. She is also outspoken, forthright, and direct in her articulation. She uses simple expressions and her language is easy, common and everyday language. Even though she seems to be quite strong in her verse, there is an emotional element attached to it. Now, let us go and have a deep and critical analysis of the poem that we have to study, The Female of the Species. Sometimes you want to talk about love and despair and the ungratefulness of children. A man is no use whatever then. You want then your mother or your sister or the girl with whom you went to through the school, and your first love and her first child, a girl, and your second. You sit with them and talk. She sews and you sit and sip and speak of the rate of rice and the price of tea and the scarcity of cheese. You know both that you have spoken of love, despair, and ungratefulness of children. This is a female-centered poem, which is clear from the title itself. And in this poem, the urge of women to share their pains and pleasures with each other is depicted. Gauri Deshpande depicts female bonding very clearly in this poem. The poet talks directly to the reader here. The use of the word you here in the poem suggests an acknowledgement of a shared experience. When a woman sits down to unburden herself, she needs women to help her. This is the central thrust of the poem, The Female of the Species. This is clear from the line, and I quote from the poem, "A man is of no use whatever then." And a woman would always like her mother or sister or her best friend to be near her in case of any crisis. Through the poem, Gauri Deshpande addresses the reader as you, and you, if you are the woman, ask your first love, that is your girl child, and your friend's first child, a girl, to attend this ceremony too. Interestingly, the ceremony here refers to the gathering of a group of housewives. It is also evident here that she deliberately underlines the fact that her friend's first child is also a girl. You have a completely closeted world where one woman talks while her friend sews. These women talk of the cost of provisions, for they are the ones who manage the house. They are the invisible accountants. The ladies do not talk of the fact that their children do not seem to be grateful for their love. Instead, they also speak of the prices of tea. They talk of basic necessities and how they juggle them, but buried within are given up dreams and ambitions that have never been given a voice. Then these women move on to speak of the scarcity of cheese, which can imply the sacrifices they have made to give their children a better future. Sacrifices their children will not understand. And though they have not really spoken to each other of the pain they feel at such behavior, this talk in itself is a means of silent communication for them. They each know what the other means, for they all share this feeling, and so in the end there is a sort of catharsis as each feels unburdened. These women are not career women but housewives who may or may not have once thought of earning their bread too. However, it seems that managing the house and the rations is something that is in the nature of a woman, as these little talks are. They have managed their affairs perfectly, but in the end of the day, as mothers, they hanker for some love or acknowledgement of the care they have bestowed. Such women can be found anywhere across India, chatting with their saris tucked in as they make a vociferous group of chattering women who seem happy and content, but within their hearts hold secret desires which were stifled or sacrificed a long time ago. Thus, through such a simple poem, Gauri Deshpande brings to the forefront the face of the hidden and silent Indian women, especially the Indian housewives. The poem, The Female of the Species, is written with lines of varied lengths. The poet, Gauri Deshpande, uses both long and short lines. By employing such a technique, Deshpande is able to give the poem a realistic touch. When we read the poem, we get the impression that we are listening to a real-life conversation. The unevenness in line length mimics real conversation to some extent. From the poem, it is clear that there is no specific rhyme scheme. The language that is used is quite simple and everyday language. The expressions employed by the poet Gauri Deshpande are strikingly straightforward and common. All these aspects go into creating the setting of domesticity and informality of a friendly banter. The speaker, the poet herself, speaks to the entire female community, as is evident from the use of the word you in the poem. From the poem, we get the impression that the speaker of the poem is very emotional. As is clear from the first few lines itself, the importance is given to the feelings and emotions. I quote a few lines of the poem here. Sometimes you want to talk about love and despair and the ungratefulness of children. As you can see, the words love, despair and ungratefulness are the ruling emotions here. The fact that this poem is addressed to the female audience is clear from the line. I quote a line from the poem here. A man is no use whatever then. Now we can talk about the setting of the poem. As you have already seen and understood, the setting is any common drawing room where a group of housewives or friends are sitting together and having tea. Gauri Deshpande, through this poem, depicts the real and common women here. In other words, she describes a stereotyped Indian housewife. Now we will come to an interesting aspect of the poem, that is the title. The title, The Female of the Species, in itself makes one conscious of the aspect of the female as the other. It is interesting to note here that the presence of the term species also makes one wonder at the exclusiveness it represents. The poet Gauri Deshpande might be hinting indirectly at the female-male dichotomy here. It could also be that Gauri Deshpande was fond of and was influenced to some extent by Darwin's work on the origin of species. It has to be noted here at this point that Charles Darwin has also written a work of the same title. However, when we talk about Darwin's theory, it has to be noted that it brought about a volte-face change in the entire gamut of human thought, especially the thoughts on the existence of human beings. In a way, the poem is also a way of changing the attitude towards and about women who are housewives. Here, one might also observe the way the poet Gauri Deshpande takes into consideration even the minute aspect of life and the world around her. Yet, Gauri Deshpande's human beings are not unnecessarily pessimistic, and she herself does not leave them entirely to fate. They struggle heroically with even a more invigorated soul and spirit. They emerge tragic, no doubt, yet they are great with essentially human virtues even in their supposedly tiny and insignificant endeavors. As I have already mentioned in the earlier discussions, the tone of the poem is a bit emotional, as it revolves around despair and ungratefulness. This aspect is very important as it highlights and supports the themes in the poem. If we have to analyze Gauri Deshpande's The Female of the Species, the major theme of this female-centered narrative would be filial ingratitude. Along with that, and equally important, is the lack of understanding and consideration shown towards women in Indian society. The behavior of men towards women is also hinted at here in subtle levels. From Gauri Deshpande's point of view, when a woman needs to have a heart-to-heart talk on love and despair or about their children, talking to a man has no value. The words love and despair make one wonder at the nature of these feelings and how women manage to cope with these issues, where most of the time they do not have anyone to share their feelings with. It is a common belief that no matter how much a mother has to tolerate, she is fated to love her children, and so perhaps in this context of their perceived ungratefulness, the feeling of despair manifests itself. Another important aspect in the poem is the way Gauri Deshpande looks at the moral degradation that has come into the modern Indian society. This is very clear from the way children treat their parents, especially mother, and how this treatment affects the mother and how this treatment takes place is critically examined in this simple poem. Gauri Deshpande can hardly see any particle of happiness where moral values are cheaper than a few kilos of meat, where an ambassador car is cared more than a wife. Even children love their aging parents for their rich inheritance. In such a complex web of life, Gauri Deshpande feels gloomy and almost stunned by the everyday life. As is evident from the following lines from the poem The Female of the Species, I quote, "You sit with them and talk, she sews and you sit and sip, and speak of the rate of rice and the price of tea and the scarcity of cheese. You know both that you have spoken of love and despair and ungrateful children." Thus, from these lines, we can see that the women hide their feelings inside even when they talk about the random things in their everyday life. Even when they discuss about tea and the price of cheese and the scarcity of cheese, all of these housewives have in their minds the despair and loneliness that they feel at the ungrateful behavior of their children and the family. Now let us look at few of the critical comments on Gauri Deshpande's poetry. First of all, let us look at the comment of the critic Sherwin T. Carr on Gauri Deshpande's poetry. He says, "She, Gauri Deshpande, is a mature poet aware that neither passion nor disillusionment are simple emotions, and the texture of her best poetry is accordingly complex. Most of her verse is marked by a sense of sadness and loss." Now let us look at the comment of another well-known and renowned critic and poet, K.K.N. Daruwala. He says about the poetry of Gauri Deshpande thus, "Anchored in the world around her, Gauri Deshpande's poetry deals with the minute details of everyday life. The coming of a lover, the death of a puppy dog, ingratitude of children. Everything is grist to her mill, from city with its greasy caress and harsh endearments to a treescape." Even the critics are of the opinion that Gauri Deshpande's verse is characterized by the life of the everyday common man. This simplicity in her themes and verses make her poetry even more attractive. Dear viewers, with that we come to the conclusion of this lesson. I hope you have enjoyed this lesson and see you in the next lesson. Thank you.